Hey, it's John Tebow, Far East Travels here in Taipei, Taiwan, and I'm here at a place where actually Anthony Bourdain, we're all talking about Anthony Bourdain this week, the unfortunate loss of Anthony Bourdain, and he actually had this particular dessert right here 6 years ago, this particular special dessert shop here near the Ningxia Night Market in Taipei, Taiwan. So in his honor, I thought I would have a mango ice right here in the same spot he sat 6 years ago when he did a episode of the Layover television show when he came to Taipei, Taiwan. That's the last time that I know that he was here, and he visited lots of places, but this place I particularly researched out and found out that he had a mango ice here. So in his honor, I'm doing that today. And all kinds of noise around me because it's just after 4 o'clock. And people are getting set up for the night market that sets up every day here. So I'm doing this broadcast in 360, so you can actually spin around and see some of where some of the noise is going on right now, and gives you an idea actually of the environment. Now it's pretty quiet here because it's in the sort of mid-afternoon. At night, this place is extremely busy, and usually all these seats are taken most nights of the week. This is a really popular night market for tourists to come to, and it's just one of the kind of places that Anthony Bourdain would constantly feature in his show. Everyday places that people would go to, not always the fancy restaurants, not always the luxurious places. That's what I liked about Anthony Bourdain. What I was inspired by him the most was to go to the places that weren't the glossy, glitzy places, the places that maybe were a little bit edgy. They didn't look pretty, but they had great food, and there was great adventure and great stories to come from visiting those places. So I guess, you know, and thinking back on Anthony Bourdain and the impression that he left on me and the inspiration he left on me, these were some of the things that, you know, pretty much came into inspiring me to do what I do today. So in his honor, mango ice. And this, of course, is a specialty of Taiwan, and we're in mango season, so this is the best time of year to enjoy mango ice in Taiwan. Taiwan mangoes are so sought after. They're some of the most prized mangoes in East Asia, and people from all over the region come here all the time to enjoy mango ice, especially in the summer months. And we're right in the middle of the mango season right now, so there's actually all kinds of wonderful tropical fruit available almost all year round in Taiwan, but mango season is such a special season because this is one of the most famous desserts that you could ever have in Taiwan is mango ice. So cheers, Anthony Bourdain. Thank you for everything.